Gauteng Chief Inspector of Labour and Employment, Advocate Michael Mseza, is visiting the 64-year-old domestic worker, Mamkabonina Mkonza, who was allegedly attacked at the home of her employer in what is suspected to be a racial attack. Now, the Provincial Labour Department is there to get a statement from the victim. This after Newsroom Africa covered the story recently. Now, for the latest on this developing story, I'm joined now on the line by the Gauteng Chief Inspector of Labour and Employment, Advocate Michael Mseza. Advocate, good to talk to you this afternoon. Now, what is the latest on this particular case? We know that investigations are currently underway. The suspect was released on a bail of 500 rand.
Good afternoon to your listeners. I've been to the home of Ms. Kabonina Mkonza. In fact, I'm still in fact, and now I'm talking to you. And I've established a team of investigators from the temporary that we have, covering different constituencies. And from the investigation, now we have established that indeed Ms. Kabonina Mkonza works for an employer in question. And we have also established that the employer is entirely a medical dealer, also was working in the medical field as a dentist, or who was fighting as a dentist. And therefore, contrary to what others might have known to say, it's actually a domestic worker. It's not in terms of the race, it's actually a cleaner that's working for a scope data. It must be stated as such, was working in the home of the employer.
Now, with the case that's currently on now, who laid the initial charges against the 28-year-old Christian Muller?
Well, we are aware that there are charges that are open in the police, but they have not engaged the police as so far. But we do have the statement that indeed there are charges linked and they came out of in terms of things. But then what we did in our case was to go and verify in terms of compliance with our legislation and to check if indeed the lady works for the employer and from when to the lady works for the employer. From what she said is that she started working for the employer from the 9th of May 1998. But in terms of our records held by the Unemployment Insurance Fund, she is registered from March 1999. But for that period of 22 years that she has been working with the employer has not paid anything to the fund. Neither has the employer made any declaration nor contribution, which is a very serious violation of our laws. And secondly, the lady is not reflecting under the compensation fund. So it means that she is either on duty now. The other challenge is that the employer has not registered under the compensation fund, nor has she submitted any return of any, nor any assessment, nor any payment. And that is another serious violation that the preliminary was established. And we have also noted that the lady was actually earning 3,000 per month prior to the lockdown, and from the lockdown, 4,000 per month, waiting from 8 o'clock in the morning until 9 o'clock in the evening. And they will have to then go and calculate in terms of the national minimum wage of 72 cents per hour, and check an overtime payment that could not have been paid up so far. So those are all challenges that we've got to investigate. And once we have investigated this, then we'll be in contact with the investigating officer from the police side and in contact with the National Prosecuting Authority NC if there are violations and other things. But what we'll also do, we'll subpoena the employer so that then we can have records and give him a chance to the story on his side to either collaborate or rebut his allegations that are made by the lady and those that we get from the records of our investigation.
So clearly, from what you're saying, this case is beyond the case of assault to other labor-related issues that you've just highlighted now. So what is Mamkabonina's current situation? Is she still working for that particular employer?
In terms of the law, she is still working for the employer because she's not dismissed. Neither has she got any word from the employer because she's no longer working for an employer. But I must say that she's at home and badly injured, that I must say. And we shall also check, yes, indeed, that this is beyond the case of only an assault because it goes beyond that because now she got injured at the workplace. And once somebody has got an incident at the workplace, it is a duty of that employer to report that incident. And no incident has been reported to my office in terms of Section 24 of Occupational Health and Safety Act and neither has any incident been reported to the Foundation Fund, because her injury was supposed to fall, supposed to be treated as an injury on this.
So what type of advice are you giving her at this particular time? And I guess not only her, but many others who may find themselves in similar situations where they get injured on the workplace.
Every person that that injured at the workplace must ensure that that employer reports such an injury to the Department of Employment and Labor. And if the employer does not do that, the person also has the right to go to approach the nearest office of the Department of Employment and Labor and report such injury. It doesn't matter whether that injury is a measure of whatever tools or whatever that the CEO was using when he got injured. Or can it be the result of the assault by the employee himself or herself? In that way, he still constitutes an injury or injury and it's reportable to us.
I wonder if you can comment on this. What is the current nature of the relationship between Mom Kabonina and her employer, given the fact that she's still working there and yet there are charges against the son of that family?
Well, from a face deal, we would say that the relationship has irreversibly broken down. That's how we say it. But in terms of the law, Mom Kabonina Mkhonza is still the employee of the employer. And as such, will have to keep her as such and make sure that all rights and privileges accorded to the employee are also accorded to her. And if then if it's not on duty, it must be clear that it's not on duty because to not be on duty, to speak loud is different and there is that to an extent that it's not appropriate.
Before I let you go, Advocate, you say from your observation that this relationship seems to have irrevocably broken down. Do you have any insight as to perhaps why Mom Kabonina's employers did not endeavor to release her or fire her, or did they try to do that at some point?
Well, she has not alleged anything from that angle. She has not said that the employer wanted to fire her. What she alleged is that she was beaten on political issues, which in that way would not be that are related to employment. But in our case, we do not have evidence that they suggested that the employer wanted to fire her, apart from the incident that happened. And as a result of that, that she is not on duty because she's allegedly beaten by the employer, then that is why we say the relationship is severely broken down, because under those circumstances, it would be difficult for her to go back and report to duty until she has the clarity and the directive from us to what it is must be done for the subject for the
Advocate, thank you for your time this afternoon.